Modern Wahine Hawaii is presented by Inspiration Interiors, home fashion with an attitude. I'm Brooke Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii.
Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. Don't adjust your screens, you're not seeing double. This is Leanne Mayberry, my executive producer. We're finally twinning in our core adorables.
After a whole year of episodes.
We're mind melding. I like your dress.
Hey, you too.
Aren't we cute? We're so cute. We're like a singing group.
I love it.
Our final episode of the season.
Oh my gosh.
Season one.
It's a wrap.
I'm gonna cry. So let's talk about what some of our fave moments were on this, year around the sun, if you will. What pops out in your brain?
We had so many incredible guests on.
Yes, we did.
One that comes to mind, we had quite a few Olympians on, actually.
We did.
And, of course, Christy Yamaguchi. Mm. And being able to be out on the ice with her, even though I was on a seal.
Yes.
That your husband was pushing me on,
yes,
to get the tracking shot.
You were getting the shots.
You know, whatever you need to do.
Because
that was
a
cool.
A beauty queen went down in that shot.
That is true.
Yeah.
That is true.
But it was fun.
That was
Christy's
amazing.
Great.
Oh, fantastic.
Christy's great. She's always welcomed on the show. I don't know. For me, like, we had Bethany Hamilton. We had Carissa Moore.
Yeah. Oh.
It's so hard to choose. I don't know where, if I had to choose, what would mine be? Oh, you know what?
What's that?
Because I need everything twice, Hawaii. It'd have to be food and wine.
I thought you might say that.
Because,
that was a good episode.
Come on. Denise Yamaguchi hooked it up.
Definitely. MW Restaurant.
MW Restaurant, which I'd never been to until we covered it, and now you can't get rid of me. I'm like an alley cat. I'm there all the time.
We ate our way through the dessert menu,
yes,
while we were there.
Because so. Michelle is amazing, so is her husband. Mm-hmm. I loved doing that episode. But it's like trying to pick your favorite child. Like, you can't really choose.
No, we had a great time. You want to know what I think was a mutual favorite?
What?
When we went to Camp Erdman.
Oh, yes.
That was definitely one of our most memorable times.
Tossie Reed, my girl, was holding me down because I was going to phone it in and, like, just end it on the second plateau. And I was like, no, I'm good.
She made you get all the way
cut
to the
we
top.
We could cut. And she's like, come on, we're never going to be here again. Who knows when we're going to be back here? We should make it to the top. And like Fortnite, we made it all the way to the top.
You guys did great. I was really impressed.
I was doing it just so that you would go on that little swingy thing. Because if I didn't make it to the top, you weren't going to do it. So that was fueling my internal fire.
I could tell. I could tell. You seemed really enthusiastic as you were hoisting me to the top of the platform.
And then you swang, is that a word? Like George of the Jungle.
Back
and forth. It was amazing. I hope we have that on a reel somewhere, on a loop. Because
it's pretty hilarious.
You look good.
Thank you.
You didn't have a thing with heights like I do.
You know what? It was really fun, and I was focusing on producing while I was, being posted,
Yeah, that was cute, because you were, like, being hoisted up. You were like, make sure that the camera's in focus. Make sure you have me in frame, because I'm going to swing this way. And I was like, just swing. Like,
I don't think I had a lot of time to be nervous until I got to the very top.
And it was high.
And it was. It was
very,
very high. But it was a beautiful view from up there,
it was.
Too.
And then you had to release yourself.
Yes.
Which I was a little upset about Hawaii, I'm not going to lie. I thought I was going to get to do the releasing, but no, she was in control of the button, and then boom, there you went. Just
back
swinging back and forth. And I was like, leave her. Let her just momentum it out. It was fun.
That was a great time. We had a lot of fun this season.
Yes.
Thank you for everything that you've done.
Can't believe it's been a whole year of episodes, buddy.
Yeah.
It went pretty quick.
It was.
Considering.
It really was. And we have, so many great moments.
Yeah.
And, of course, I had to compile a few of my personal favorites.
Uh-oh. That don't sound right.
Well.
What'd you do?
The blooper reel.
Oh, okay.
I think it's what our audience would want to see.
I don't know if Hawaii wants to see a blooper reel of me. No.
Well, prepare yourselves. So here are some of my favorite moments that had me laughing from season one.
Hands in, everybody.
Hands in.
Shimazo. Don't die.
Wait, I'm having dress anxiety. Is that her belly button I'm seeing right now? Is that a piercing?
That's not a thing. I don't have that.
She can hear everything we're saying.
Oh.
Covered.
Roger.
No one told us about this part.
Just follow me. Okay, when I turn, you turn.
Yeah, when she moves, I move.
Yes.
Okay.
When I dip, you dip, we dip. Yes.
And then I'll eat a cookie. Well, I'm going to eat it one. Okay. When I toss a break. Okay. I deserve it. Okay.
Oh, you want me to say it now? I thought this was the insert. Oh my God, Leanne.
7 minutes. Your left.
Brooke. I don't work at a ranch. I don't know what her quote was. I'm a beauty queen. I'm allowed to do that.
A beauty queen and a gold medalist down.
Well, look in your little magical box. That's hidden in your Harry Potter's Chamber of Secrets. Can you imagine? I just totally forget and I just rip the thing out, like splatters of blood across the...
I said apple bra on camera.
Apple bra.
I know, I don't know if that'll make the final.
I doubt it will.
Am I tilted?
We could sit like this.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Hey, with Susan the apple
Thank you. How are you? What's happening with my world? There's no hair, no camera. Why am I being punished?
No montages of me clapping like a seal. Ow. I hurt myself.
That's going on the blooper reel. I can totally tell now.
You're good with the clapping montage. That was clever.
I had to put it to a beat.
Thank you for the blooper reel.
Godspeed.
Oh boy, you're so funny.
I'm just teasing. You did a great job this season, Brooke. It was fun.
Well, you know, we should clap it out one more time.
Should we?
Yeah, right. Let's do it.
Right about here.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
I'm here with Angie Dolan, who is the Academic Dean and College Advisor over at La Pietra. Hi, Angie.
Hi, Brooke. Thanks for having me.
Sure. So much to talk about in these times. I was wondering, you know, because of how fast everyone had to respond to COVID-19, what are some of the things that La Pietra had to put in place?
Yeah, so we were given maybe a 1 to 2 week window before we really had to transition and go full throttle for a distance learning plan. So what the things we really wanted to take into consideration were, you know, first and foremost, the health and safety of our students and faculty, and then also the considering the different circumstances each family was going through. Many of them lost their jobs, they had different access to internet and computers at home. So when we formulated our plan, we really wanted to make it the most equitable and accessible for all our students so that no student felt like they were being penalized given the situation.
And then, you know, the class of 2020 all over the world really had kind of a rough transition. How did you guys anticipate and help with the forward, you know, thinking of what college expectations were going to be for your seniors? How did you guys work through that?
Yeah, so the good and bad with the class of 2020 is most of them by March had already received decisions about what colleges they wanted to go to. So it really became an issue of financial aid, if students were going to take another SAT or standardized test. A lot of the stress also came from, you know, their fourth term and having colleges, you know, look at that and hopefully not penalize them for that. So a lot of colleges actually said they weren't going to hold that fourth term or that last semester against them or rescind any admissions decisions. So that really helped, I think, ease the stress of the students who were just trying to finish up strong.
Right. And so, you know, I'm a parent on all of our minds going forward. You know, we're stepping into summer, but everyone's got 2020, 2021 on their minds. What's school going to look like? What it's going to feel like? Do you guys have any sort of plans in place on how it is you guys think you're going to be able to weather whatever comes up next?
Yeah, that's a great question. We're knee deep in planning, as I'm sure most schools are, but we're also very wary that the situation could change in a few weeks or in a few months. So again, with the priority being the safety of our students and employees, we're really trying to bring our students back in a safe way so they do have the physical classes, which again is our strength and what we hope to serve our students. We do think we're small enough to bring all students back and safely distance. Our class sizes are anywhere from 5 to 12 to begin with. So with some additional facilities work, I think we'll be able to manage that safely.
Right. Well, I just want to thank you all at La Pietra. You guys have been so wonderful on our show, and we're just grateful to be able to be a partner with you guys. And we wish you guys all the best as you guys head into the next season.
Thank you so much. Thank you for highlighting our strengths and our identity and putting that out in the community. So we're very proud of our alumni and our achievements, and very happy that you guys partnered with us as well.
I'm here with Amy Thomas from Ulta Beauty. Hi, Amy.
Hi, Brooke.
We're talking exclusivity today at Ulta.
Yes, we are.
Love that. Let's get into it.
Okay, fantastic. Well, as you mentioned, these products we're going to talk about today are exclusive to Ulta Beauty. And one of the things our guests always are looking for are the newest, latest, and greatest. And just like our guests, we are always on the hunt for the newest and the best up-and-coming brands. So first of all, we've got our Kylie Lip Duo. So it comes with a matte lipstick and a matching liner, and it's a perfect way to get the perfect lip all in one simple duo. This next item and brand I'm super excited about, Florence by Mills, inspired by Millie Bobby Brown. And this particular product is a glow peel-off mask, and this is one of my daughter's absolute favorite products, and she's a huge fan of Florence. The charcoal in it helps bring out the toxins. The witch hazel in it helps really balance out the skin and keep it fresh and happy.
Nice.
And then another really great brand for us that we have launched is Pattern by Tracee Ellis Ross. And these two products here, we have our hydrating shampoo. So really great for the coily, curly, highly, tightly textured hair to really give it that nourishment and cleanse. And then with that, it's paired with the conditioner.
Nice. So let's talk about the It brushes for Ulta Beauty, because those are some of my favorites.
Yeah, I love hearing that they're your favorites. And It exclusive for Ulta Beauty, this particular set is one you're definitely gonna have to have, because it does have all of the different brushes for the different types of techniques. We've got our Morphe Boss Mood palette with just a really beautiful array of colors within one single eye palette. A great way to really try out different looks, experiment, just play and have fun. And you really can't have too many eye palettes, in my opinion. And then one brand that's near and dear to our hearts that we absolutely love is our very own Ulta Beauty collection. And here today we have a couple of products out of that collection. We have our Watermelon Sleeping Mask, which is great to put on just as it's titled, while you're sleeping, and you wake up with that really radiant, glowing skin in the morning. And then also we have featured here our Ulta Beauty Lip and Cheek Stick. So kind of a two-in-one. So really easy to take with you on the go when you need to.
I see Tutti Frutti here.
You see some Tutti Frutti. So this is our Too Faced. It's by Too Faced. It's Tutti Frutti. It's the illuminating drops. Illumination, dewiness, still something that's very on trend. And again, I don't think you can have too much shimmer in your
life. Never.
And then finally, this little cutie here is our Tarte Sugar Rush Lip Oil. So when I think about the tropical climate, or if you're in the ocean with the salt and the sea air, it's just a really fantastic product to keep your lips hydrated.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for all of this exclusive product. You can't find it anywhere else except Ulta Beauty or online, right?
Correct, yes.
Thank you so much for being here, Amy.
Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
I'm here one aloha oi time with Julia from Inspiration Interiors. Hi, Julia.
Hi, Brooke. How are you?
I'm good. I'm a little sad. I'm not going to lie. This is like our Paulhana episode for season one. Can you believe it?
I actually can't. It has just flown by. And to talk about the things that have happened, you know, just this past year.
What are some of the things that stick out in your mind?
I think the first couple months, every time I was shooting with you, I was just so nervous and excited. And I absolutely loved building all the sets and, you know, trying to make sure everything looked good on camera and then being able to actually see it when it was played, how it looked, you know? Yeah.
I gotta say, I'm one of the most spoiled hosts in the history, I think, of television. No one gets to say they get a brand new set every week. Every time I'd come in on a Monday to shoot, it was like Christmas. It was like a whole new me, you know what I'm saying? It was an honor to be able to work with you and get to know you over the course of the season and to watch you just sort of become the TV star you are through it all. So, you know, now that we've sort of survived, you know, we're kind of coming out on the other side with the pandemic. And how are things going over there at the Honolulu Design Center?
They're actually going as well as they possibly can. We have opened all three locations, and I'm thinking everybody feels extremely safe. We have sanitizing stations. Everybody has been fabulous with wearing their masks. And really, we've taken our time to just extra clean the showrooms all the time. And we just opened Stage and Amuse as well, which was so, so, so exciting. And we had a great turnout. Reservations are required right now just because we want to make sure that we are keeping our distance and, you know, being really safe about how we're seating people and how many people we let into the restaurant. But it was absolutely wonderful to see everybody out and enjoying a night and having a glass of wine. So that was really exciting.
I feel like people just feel like they've been cooped up for so long. They just want to not eat a home cooked meal, right?
Definitely.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Julia. I'm a little sad, but you know, I'm still going to haunt you every now and then and come down and poke my little head in to say hello.
Definitely.
And I'm sure we'll be seeing each other because we're like wonder twins. I mean, you can't keep us apart.
No, definitely not.
It's been so great to be a part of such a historic, wonderful ride with you in season one of Modern Wahine Hawaii. Our love to everybody over at the Design Center. We love you guys so much.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, so I'm excited that we have our friend Carol Isozaki from Strategic Brand Intelligence. She's gonna share a lot of important information with us today. Hi Carol.
Hi Brooke.
We've got a lot to talk about, Carol.
Yeah, we do. Things have changed a lot. Yeah.
Lots been happening. So let's kind of delve in because it's a lot for people to wrap their brain around what's going on in the world right now. For me personally, being at home and working from home, it's a different mindset. It's sort of the mixing of the two that I think maybe a lot of people are trying to become familiar with. And so patterns that were working for them, the go-tos from before, may not work going into the future. Like how do they kind of mitigate that?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. You know, when we put go-to moves together, they absolutely make sense as a strategy. You know, they help to ensure the right outcomes. But one of the things that I find when I work with people all the time is that we put the go-to moves in a long time ago and circumstances and priorities change. And, you know, right now there's a seismic shift in circumstances and priorities. And we don't revisit our go-to moves. And so over time, those go-to moves that served us well, often they cause results that we don't want. They cause added stress or guilt or anything, you know, along those lines. And so, you know, for me, yeah, this is the perfect time to be reevaluating what our go-to moves are. And, you know, to me, it starts with really paying attention to how we're feeling, right? If we're feeling depleted or stressed or guilty, then really thinking about, okay, what is causing that? And how do I need to change that up? And really understanding that we have so much power within us to change our circumstance. You know, self-care to me starts with being willing to be vulnerable, be willing to put down our poker face. And so much of the time we think that, no, I need to be strong. I need to be there for everybody else. And what we need to acknowledge is it is harder right now. Everything is more stressful. It's more depleting. And we need to recognize that we have resources all around us, and it is courageous, it is strategic to admit that we're struggling, admit that we need help. I did a post recently on LinkedIn where I took a picture of my tulips, and my tulips do not grow straight up. They grow sideways, and then just the flower part comes up, and it's because they're looking for the sun. They thrive in the sun. And my point was that even though these tulips are rooted, as we are rooted right now, they have the ability to reach and get the help and what they need to thrive. And that's what I want all of us to appreciate, is that, you know, even though we are rooted right now, help is within reach. It's our responsibility to have discussions, engage with people, admit our vulnerabilities. It makes everyone else feel more comfortable. It makes them feel that they could share their struggles too and know that they're not the only ones. We're all human beings and we all need to admit that. And it actually makes us all stronger when we do.
Awesome. Well, thanks again so much, Carol. This has been so great. It's a lot of information that's really going to help a lot of people, especially here in Hawaii. So thank you so much for being on.
Thank you. I appreciate the invite back, and I hope to do it in person again someday too.
Fingers crossed. We'll see you soon.
Can you believe it's been a year?
It's been crazy.
It went like that.
I'm really, you know what, Rook, I'm really, really proud of you. You've done an amazing job this year. Honored to be your EP.
Aww.
And I'm really excited about the stories that we got to share as well.
I'm a little nervous that we're dressing alike, I'm not gonna lie. We're gonna have to work on that.
This is gonna be the uniform for next season, I hope you know.
It's gonna have to be a thing. But you know what, I'm so grateful to all of the sponsors as well, because without them we couldn't do the show. And we got a good mix of people, but they're all good people.
Yeah,
and
great
team. And I mean, every story has been just amazing to be a part of. And you've been amazing because, you know, you're an executive producer to the stars, and I love you. Season two.
Season two, that's what's ahead.
Where are we gonna go?
Oh, so many places.
The moon.
Or another island?
Or the moon, or both. You'll just never know. So, hey, K-high-five.
K-high-five.
Thanks, Hawaii. We love you. We'll see you next season.
Modern Wahine Hawaii was filmed on location at Inspiration Interiors, Hawaii's best value in home furnishings.